What's up, Simlings? Welcome back to the channel, or welcome if you're new. I'm Nay, I play The Sims. Let's get into it. This is our first play at Eco Lifestyle. Here we are in Evergreen Harbour, which you'll notice in my intro, I have spelled H-A-R-B-O-U-R, which is the Queen's English way, which is the correct way. There are three neighbourhoods within Evergreen Harbour. Up in the top left there, we have Grimm's Quarry. To the far right, we have Conifer Station, which ill conifers stink, and where we are beginning is in Port Promise, which is the smelly little industrial bit. We are beginning our adventure at The Caboose, which is a bit of a dive bar. Our little sim here is Kovu Rydell, and I've set her up with the mission to change the eco footprint of Port Promise. So we're just going to start here in The Caboose, just meeting people. Trying to meet the locals, which didn't really work out because we've got a Bjergsen and a Fires who are definitely not local to Port Promise. But we also have Francine here, who she's a bit of a party looking at those traits there. She looks like she's going to be some fun. The very first thing you'll notice once you hit Port Promise is the terrible air quality, which your Sims cough a lot, and it's a dry hacking cough. They are suffering. But just to make things worse, we're going to go dumpster diving because, you know, that's so much better for your health. And you see, I got very excited about a little ratty there. I like rats. They're very cute. Even if they spread disease, they're adorable. But here with our dumpsters, we can dive for deals, dive for meals, dive for ingredients. And we can even nap in the dumpster if that's what you're into. But here we go. We're diving. We're having a look. In we go. Go dig deep, see what we can find. Legs in the air, just... This is a very graceful maneuver here. Has Kovu found anything? What's she got? Da-da-da! We found some money! That's actually pretty sweet. Can't complain about that. We're going in again. What are we going to find this time? I love the kicking legs. Just really getting in there, getting right to the bottom. Exploring the world a little bit further, we're now at the community space in Conifer Station, which I see lots of conifers, which is gross because they smell super bad. But having a look at the community space voting board, three things we can vote for are the community garden, the makerspace, and the marketplace, which all sounds super cute and are right up my Sims alley. But this isn't the neighbourhood I live in, so I can't vote on any of these, which I didn't realise at the time when I was messing around, that you can only vote depending on which neighbourhood you're in. You can't vote for all three, so you can't alter the community spaces. The community garden space is exactly as it says. It's a community garden. The maker space is a place for your fabricator sims to work on their fabrications and creations. It's basically a major recycling center. That one is really, really cool. And then the third one is the marketplace, which is, it allows for your crafter sims to sell their created goods. So I haven't seen that one yet. Spoiler alert, that's the only one I haven't seen, but that one, it sounds pretty cool. Can't wait to try that one on a bit later. But as I said, you can only vote on the community space the neighbourhood you're in, so we'll have to come back to that later. But hanging around the community space here, we ran into Tina Tinker, who is the queen of the crochet pants. Gotta love them. They would be super heavy when wet. Don't fall in a lake. I don't know what made me think of that. These spaces are super empty. Like, there's not much to do except for this fridge. How sad is that? Someone's just abandoned a fridge out here. And we're going dumpster diving again. We're back in the dumpster. What are we going to find here? Does Conifer Station have anything more to offer than a couple of bucks? Hi, Barco. Just eating your rotten food and standing right in my way, getting kicked in the shoulder. If that's your thing, go for it. Hey, Tina. After finding not much in the dumpster, I decided to come back home to my lovely shipping container house and decided to try to do it up a bit. Could not afford any kind of refrigeration or stove device, but thought, hey, why the hell not? Let's add some, you know, let's help our eco footprint out a little bit, and we'll add a solar panel. And then it took me forever to decide where I wanted to place it because it's so important. And then back to the dumpster diving again because she was hungry. And let's be honest, the freegan trait is an absolute bitch of a trait. Your sim is always miserable. It's nearly impossible to find food in dumpsters. Oh, we're coughing again. Gotta love that air quality. But there's almost never find food in the dumpsters because some idiot's always gotten to it before you. So now we're just eating a rotten potato that I cooked up the day before, which is pretty much the same quality as the food you would find in a dumpster. So, like, still living that life a little bit, but it makes her upset because, you know, that's money wasted. And then decided it was time to plant her own vegetables, you know, help out the eco footprint a little bit more. Also, you know, she might stop whinging about spending her own money and wasting food if she's growing her own. And here's a fun thing, just be warned that you can't carry things up and down the ladder. So say, like here, I'm trying and trying and trying to delete this rotten potato, but I can't, because you can't delete food. But I also can't take it downstairs to where the sink is to clean it. So that was a huge problem. And on a side note, if you want to know where to find your eco-footprint, it's in the Seasons panel. As you can see here, our eco-footprint is industrial, which is brown, which is not good. Hitting up the caboose again with our mates Morty and Bjorn, and we're having a synchronized coughing scene. Oh, look how perfect that was. We ran into Mila Munch in the caboose, who has been raiding the custom content here, as you can see by her double nostril piercings here. Looking fabulous, Mila. And then decided it was time for Kovu to get herself a job. You damn freeloader. So your job choices are your civil designer, which is your full-time job. You can either do that rabbit hole style, or you can work from home, or you can be a fabricator, a freelancing fabricator. But I decided for Kovu, the civil designer suited her just perfectly. She wants to fix up Port Promise, so what better job to do than to be a civil designer and redesign the place? And original true pairing right here, Morty and El Faba. He's not into the idea, he hates it, but she's totally into it. And then surprise, surprise, we're back in the dumpster again. Woo, legs up in the air! Will we find anything good this time? Will it be more than $3? Will we find some food? It's time for the big reveal. What is it? It is more money. Okay, cool. No, can't complain. Money's all right. We're back in. She stinks. Oh my god. That's another problem with having an off-the-grid home, is that you can only have these tepid, crappy showers that do not get you clean. And from the caboose, we go to the waterfront, which is my community space. Woohoo! It is as bland as every other community space. Look, I can't get over how much Kovu stinks. She's just standing around, just actual stink lines coming off her. And she's just like, yeah, this is my life. We find a Greenberg here, who is one of Port Promise's locals. Mila and her piercings have traveled with us as well. Hi, Mila. Hello, piercings. But here we go, we're heading for the dumpster. I can guarantee you Mila's headed there as well, but oh, we just beat her. Take that, Mila. We're going to sort out the recyclables and the compostables. We're going to do our part for Port Promise. Going to clean out the trash, not going to send it all to landfill and be wasteful. And then, of course, we're going to go diving for our own stuff, because that's what we're here for. Got to try to find something to eat, because Kovu is not only eternally smelly, but eternally hungry. We found a plasma fruit. Not helpful, not a vampire. But here we go. We're going over to the recycling machine here to recycle some things. Not going to recycle my bee. I love my bee. But this is cool. This is where you get your bits and pieces for your candle making and your fabricating. This is a very important part of the game if you want to make it as a crafter. You recycle everything in your inventory. It's pretty comprehensive, even your fruits and vegetables, which I would call that more composting than recycling, but you know, I'm not going to argue. You get bits and pieces, so it works. And it's a pretty cool machine. It churns and cranks and crunches, and then it spits out this magical little, more coughing and stinking. Is she coughing at the bad air, or is she coughing at her own scent at this point? I'm not even sure. Oh, she knows she smells like trash. Here we go, and it will spit out, eventually. Oh, the anticipation. It spits out this cool little recycling cube that you then do nothing with. And, El Faba's here, and she's coughing up a storm too. Gross. And during that coughing fit, Kovu heads right back over to the dumpster for some more diving. See if we can find anything useful. I think we're looking for food this time. Got feet up in the air. We were desperate for food at this point, and I believe we actually found it. Ta-da! Yep. But of course that food isn't edible, so we went home to cook, and this happened. If this isn't a metaphor for my life, I don't know what is. So, it's annoying you have to tell yourself to extinguish yourself, although she just burned to death. So there was that, which made her even more miserable, and then we had to waste money on replacing the barbecue, which was exactly what I wanted to do. Then we had to shower several times, but we met Knox Greenberg, which was very useful, who was here to teach us about voting green. Unfortunately, at this point in the game, I'd figured all this out, but you know, it was nice. Maybe if I'd been home more, this would have happened earlier. But he teaches you about the neighborhood action plans and what they mean. You know, stuff like your green initiatives, your eco-friendly appliances, and your green energy production, which is all very good. That's exactly what we want to know for our little mission in life here. And then something magical happened. We traveled to the waterfront and I didn't recognize the place because suddenly it was beautiful. Look at all this greenery. Look at all these planter boxes. Look at this fence. This is as a result of voting for the community garden in the community space projects. And I was impressed. This was very cool. I could definitely see room for a few more things there, but we have a little dew collector, which is one of your green production appliances, which is very handy to have, as I found out later on. But I was so impressed with this. Once I first came in, it took me a while to figure out like what had actually happened and why there was a sudden change. And then I was like, oh, duh, like I helped for this to happen. But really cool. We've got these little, the Mighty Mite homes, your insect farms, which you can put all sorts of insects in. You have your grubs, you have your crickets, your farm beetles, and your farm bombardier beetles, which I'm not sure what they are, but they sound pretty hardcore. But you get all sorts of things from there. Apparently you can eat them. I haven't gotten to that stage yet. I've only so far been collecting bio oil, which you'll see in part two. Woo, spoiler alert, bio oil. So I just decided to start off with some grubs and some crickets in each of these, because I wasn't sure what you do at this point, because as I said, I hadn't watched any trailers, I hadn't really done much research. I wanted this, I like my expansion packs when I come in to be fresh and new and exciting. I don't like to be ruined's not the word. I don't like to be persuaded or influenced by anyone else's opinions when I jump in, so I was very excited clicking around all this and, you know, figuring it out for myself. And then every now and then, that's my virus protection dinging there. Virus protection. I meant virus protection. I can't speak. I speak faster than my brain works, so that's why you end up sometimes with just absolute garbage falling out of the hole in my face. But here we are, taking in some historical insights from this birdhouse, and then trying to kick Jeffrey Bloody Landgrab out the way, because he was showing love to the grubs, and I wanted to show love to the grubs, and I was getting super jealous, and you just need to get out of my way so that I can pick up a grub and give it a little pat and tell it how amazing it is. So move, Jeffrey, move. Don't make me get the weapons out. I don't think I have any weapons. I think in my inventory I have like a set of earbuds and some vegetables, but my god, I will beat you to death with a capsicum, Jeffrey. Move. There's a lot of pink in this shot. A lot of pink-clad women with grey hair rocking up. Did I miss the memo? Is there something going on here? Is this like a club? But here I am, I have a grub. I'm gonna give a little tickle on the head. Oh, gonna sing it a little song, rub my face on it. Wouldn't do that in real life, but I'm not Kovu. Gonna give it another little tickle. Oh, and we have Geeta in the background there, looking into a future cube. I wonder what it's telling her. But Geeta aside, as we see, Kovu is very happy with her little grub. So it's about time to move on after we've given her a little bit more love and go see what else is happening around the place. We've moved on to the quarry building here, which is another empty, boring community space. It's got a dumpster, it's got a fridge, it's got a bathtub that we can't use. It has a recycling machine, and it's just surrounded by all of this rock here, which is pretty cool. Nothing happens except for we run into this fabulous slice of fruitcake right here with his fabulous pink hair. But I believe the pink hair is a distraction because he is an NAP inspector, and that's not a good person. This is someone who hands out fines. He lures you in like an exotic bird with his pink plumage and then slaps you with a fine if you've done wrong. So I was gonna say avoid the pink hair, but then Elfaba's here and she's got a pretty rotten personality too. She just looks pretty, so maybe avoid her as well. But we're going dumpster diving because we don't go anywhere without dumpster diving. And we're kicking a lot up here. There's not much in this dumpster. It's very empty. I've not got high hopes for what we might pull out of this one. But this is actually our most successful dive yet because we find a pretty ornamental tree. Woohoo! And then from here, decided it's time for a trip to a beach in Solani for a rest. She's had a hard couple of days, you know, being a civil designer, voting on NAPs and community space projects, all that dumpster diving, all that smelling terrible because you can't have a decent shower when you're off the grid unless you have like a bajillion solar panels is my guess. With this romantic scene, we'll call an end to part one. Thank you so much for sticking around if you've made it to this point. Feel free to like, comment and subscribe, you know, all the good stuff. Stick around for part two and I'll catch you in my next video. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Hey! Oh, my neighbor's cat's in the front yard. Oh, my neighbor's cat is digging a hole and taking a dump in my front yard.
Molly! Leave!